first part I would like to cover is understanding what exactly the problem we want to solve through predictive analytics is. So what are we trying to solve exactly? What is exactly the question you are trying to answer? So we started by looking for answers to three main questions. In which ingredient category should we expect more food safety incidents in the near future? What types of food safety hazards should we expect to see more during the next 12 months? If we focus on a particular product category, such as chocolate products or dairy products, which are the most vulnerable ingredients and emerging food safety issues that we should expect? So, question number one refers to food safety incidents. The predictive analytics solutions work well only when they can be fed with quality domain-specific datasets. We refer here to two types of incidents, food product recalls and food border rejections, for example, import refusals. Practically, it asks, given that I have access to historical data about all food product recalls and border rejections that have taken place until December 2019, classified according to the raw materials, ingredients, and hazards that were linked to the recall. Is it possible to predict with high confidence how many food safety incidents we are going to have for each ingredient category in 2020? To help make decisions to mitigate food safety issues, we need risk and vulnerability assessment activities to answer critical questions such as, which are the food safety parameters that I specifically need to test for my specific products, like chocolate or dairy, for example? Which ingredients will be affected most in my supply chain? So the question here is how we can combine data technologies with human intelligence in a smart way in order to give us insights and predictions specific to the sector of the supply chain we are interested in. Just join us in the next episodes to find out the answers to the questions we mentioned here. And don't forget to subscribe to our weekly Food Safety Intelligence newsletter to stay up to date with the latest industry news. Find the link below this video.